Let me ask you something. What if tomorrow we woke up to a world where machines could think, solve problems, and make decisions better than we ever could? A world where artificial intelligence, AGI, completely changed the game, but you didn't even know it happened. Not because you weren't paying attention, but because the world you live in just wasn't invited to the table. Crazy, right? But this isn't some far-off science fiction, it's actually the direction we're heading. And today, I'm taking you on a journey to uncover what that means for the millions who are being left behind. AGI is just over the horizon. It's the next big leap from the AI we know today. This isn't just about chatbots or voice assistants anymore. AGI will be able to do it all, learn, understand, adapt, just like a human brain, only faster and way smarter. But while some of us are getting ready for this revolution, millions of people out there don't even know it's coming. And when it hits, what happens to them? Imagine two completely different worlds. In one, people are gearing up for the age of AGI, pushing the limits of technology, creating new industries, and making a lot of money in the process. In the other world, people are living the way they've always lived, maybe like their parents and grandparents before them. There's a gap, a divide, that separates those who will benefit and those who may not even know what they're missing. Now meet Maya. She's a teacher in a small village and her reality is pretty different. Internet, sometimes. Tech in the classroom, not really. Maya's students, they've never heard of artificial intelligence, while tech giants in Silicon Valley are figuring out how to make machines smarter than humans and making money from their breakthroughs, Maya's biggest challenge is just keeping her students engaged with the limited tools she has. But here's the interesting part. Even though Maya's world seems a million miles away from AGI, the decisions being made in those big cities are going to affect her and her students. Think about it. AGI could predict weather patterns for farmers in her village or stop diseases before they spread. But here's the problem. If Maya's village doesn't have the infrastructure or resources to even access these tools, how will they ever benefit from them? So, what exactly is AGI? Well, we're not quite there yet, but AGI, artificial general intelligence, will be able to think like a human, solve problems across different areas, and learn new things. It's like the AI we have today, but on a completely different level. And while we haven't reached it yet, it's coming fast, and it's going to have a massive impact on jobs, economies, and even the way we make money. So what happens if we get to that point and huge parts of the world aren't ready? Can we close that gap before it becomes impossible to cross? Or will AGI end up deepening the divide between those with access and those without, leading to even greater disparities in jobs, income, and economic growth? Here's the reality. Being left out of the AGI revolution won't just mean missing out on cool technology. It's already having serious consequences, especially when it comes to jobs and money. Let's talk healthcare. In countries where AI is already in use, doctors are using it to diagnose diseases faster and save lives. But in places like Maya's village, they're still dealing with basic shortages, and that gap is only going to grow. And education? While AGI will bring personalized learning and virtual classrooms, students like Maya's are being left behind. Without access to these tools, they're starting off in a world that's moving further and further ahead of them, creating a future where their chances for good jobs and stable incomes are already limited. Then there's the job market. In places where AGI takes over repetitive tasks, new jobs are being created that require advanced skills. But for people who aren't prepared, they risk losing their jobs to machines, with little chance of adapting to new roles. And in terms of money, the countries and communities with access to AGI will grow faster, while those without it may struggle just to stay afloat. Let's take a closer look at Sub-Saharan Africa. Here, the adoption of AI and digital tools is still in its early stages. While there are incredible minds and innovative thinkers in this region, the lack of internet access and basic infrastructure is holding them back. Businesses are struggling to compete with more developed economies, and job displacement is already happening as basic AI automation takes over low-skill jobs. Without the resources to train their workforce or the funds to build the tech infrastructure needed for AGI, this region could find itself falling even further behind. It's not just a matter of losing jobs, entire industries could be left behind. The gap between the rich and poor will grow, and the opportunities to create new money-making ventures will be even more limited. So what can we do about it? Here's the thing. We don't have to wait for AGI to be here to start preparing. The solution lies in making sure everyone has the opportunity to get involved, no matter where they are. First, it starts with education. Right now, there are grassroots movements around the world bringing tech education to underserved areas. They're teaching kids in villages like Maya's how to code, how to think critically about technology, and how to build their own solutions. These are the skills that will help them land the future jobs that will come with AGI. Second, infrastructure is key. Governments and organizations need to invest in providing access to reliable internet and digital tools. It's not just about connecting cities, it's about making sure even remote communities are connected, so they can access the same opportunities to improve their livelihoods and create money-making opportunities. Third, we need collaboration. This isn't just one country's problem or one industry's challenge. Governments, tech companies, and educational institutions need to work together to make sure AGI serves everyone. There are already projects that focus on building partnerships between developed and developing countries to share knowledge, invest in technology, and ensure that no one is left behind in this global job and money revolution. But here's where you come in. The truth is, it's not just up to governments or big organizations. We all have a role to play in making sure AGI benefits everyone. If you're in a position to mentor or teach, share your knowledge. Whether it's teaching coding or simply helping someone get familiar with new technology, those small actions can make a huge difference in someone's ability to land future jobs and create new opportunities to earn money. If you're an entrepreneur or innovator, think about how you can bring technology to places that don't have easy access. You don't have to wait for the perfect infrastructure. There are creative ways to bring solutions to even the most remote areas, helping communities create new money-making opportunities and become part of the global digital economy. And if you're a policymaker, push for policies that focus on equitable access to technology. It's not enough to build AGI. We need to make sure it's available to everyone, giving people access to the future of jobs and economic prosperity. The rise of AGI is coming, and its impact, that's still in our hands. The solutions are here, and they're happening all around us, from education to infrastructure to collaboration. We have the power to make sure this technology serves everyone, not just the few. So the question is, what role will you play? Will you stand by and watch, or will you help shape the way AGI changes our world and impacts jobs and money for the better? The future of AGI is coming, and the real question is, what will it mean for you and your ability to shape the future of jobs and money? I mentioned earlier that we are still far from AGI, but if you want to predict like an expert when we will achieve AGI, watch this video.
How soon will artificial general intelligence, or AGI for short, that can think and learn like human actually arrive? Experts like Elon Musk, Dennis Hassabis, or Sam Altman say by 2030. But what about your prediction?